So, according to my aunt, this is where bottled water first started. Yeah, that's right, you heard me. Bottled water. One of the worst inventions in the world. Well, unfortunately, I use bottled water, so I can't really talk too much. But yeah, where they first started putting water in a bottle and selling it.
Was built around this water bar. And the water bar had all these different spigots in here that came up like this. And you got different water. You got iron water. I can't even think of all the waters that were here.
Yeah, they had four different.
What were they?
Iron, manganese, calcium, soda, and salt.
Okay. This was my very first job at this water bar when I was 12 years old.
Oh, wow.
And I worked there the summer I was 12 and the summer that I was 13.
Wow, I bet it was busy, wasn't it?
It was busy back then. Yeah, because that would have been, let's see, at 12, it would have been 1980.
Yeah.
And they still had all the different, the spigots were here.
Yeah, they just recently fenced. Well, of course, they'd been disconnected, but they just recently tore all. Just in the last year.
So are some of these pictures of what it looked like before?
Yeah, I think if you look around, you might see. It seems like there's one that's got some pictures of people standing at the water bar.
Okay.
Maybe for me. That is
so the water came from different springs, right?
They piped 10 of them into the building.
Okay, that's what I thought. I couldn't remember all of it. Oh, see, soda, iron, magnesium, calcium waters. Oh, here we go. The Springs Pavilion Bottling Works, 1880 to 1936. And this was in the basement. Remember I told you, this is where they started bottling water.
Yeah.
And that sulfosaline water tasted horrible. And it smelled crappy too. Oh, here we go. So they had all these, all these bathtubs back there and people would come and soak in the bathtubs. Oh, here, Turkish bath, Russian bath, cabinet bath, Swedish massage, and salt rub. And so yeah, they would come to these, they were called the sanitarium and bathhouse. And look how neat the old buildings were. Oh, and that's the Salem bathhouse that's down the street. But the whole town, a big chunk of it was based on these bathhouses. Oh, these were the first like massage therapists that were in the area. And they were at the Doxy bathhouse on Broadway. Pretty neat, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, there's all the little hotels and boarding houses. Where's that one? Oh, the Maples. Dad worked at the Maples. And Hotel Plaza, the Benton Park House. Pickwick Apartments. Aunt Judy used to live there. Oh, I actually have some black and white pictures and some of the stuff in the garage of some of these. They were little cards that you could buy. Oh, look. Here's the evolution of the treatment. Oh, see? We can walk back there and see these. But people used to come here and they would want to get in the different water because the different water is what made you feel good. That's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, a lot of these little houses like this are still standing, but none of these little bathhouses, none of those water houses. These are little gems, 20 structures housing springs that scattered throughout Excelsior Springs. Each pavilion was unique and had a distinct personality with superior pagodas above it, built in 1912.
Sorry, the reflection's bad.
Yeah. Nothing I can do. I was going to try to block it for you.
Yeah.
I've got black and white pictures of these in the garage.
All right.
Oh, so this is what I was telling you about. All these people from all over the world wanted to come to Excelsior Springs and sit in these bathtubs because, you know, of course, history and, you know, times have changed, but everybody wanted to sit in these bathtubs because, like, if you had arthritis, it was supposed to help your arthritis. Oh. Oh, you can't see it in the picture. This is where we went to the barbecue. They had to tear this part down because it got decrepit. Oh, yeah, there's a big golf park on the north side of town. And where we came down, oh, Lake Maurer, Triss Falls. I don't know anything about this auditorium building. I don't know anything about it. But that's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, and these are the people that started it. And remember, I went to Wyman Elementary, and he was the one who started the elementary school. And the Isley family, there's still a lot of Isleys in Excelsior Springs and a bunch of Morse.
I've heard that Morse name before.
Wow, this went on until 1975 from 1901. Oh, wow, they put on Arbor Day at Watkins Mill. I remember going to that as a kid. Oh, wow. That's pretty neat, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. I told you, Harry Truman was this big fan of coming to Excelsior Springs.
I've seen this picture before here. I don't know who that is, but I've seen her picture before. Her picture, and I think her picture before.
Okay, Mae Jones and O.C. Snap.
Maybe they were church members.
Maybe. Okay, do you know who this is?
No.
Famous gangster Al Capone.
Oh!
Yeah, President Truman and Dr. Wallace Graham and, you know, Joe Louis, the boxer.
Obviously
he came.
Marilyn Monroe.
No, that's Brenda Joyce and Donald Judd.
Oh.
And Greg Williams. Greg Williams is the one who gave Dad his Lifetime Achievement Award when we came for that.
Oh, and that was a long time ago.
And then President Truman, remember I told you he was a huge fan of the Elms.
Right.
That's pretty interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh. Boy, there isn't very many of these. This is the Excelsior Springs Museum now, but I'm not sure what it was then. This is Wyman Elementary School. But sign on it says New High School because it was a high school before it was the elementary school. Oh, look at this. Ever-changing climates. Even in this day, in 1960, everyone was worried about it.
Right.
Natural and man-made. Oh, this is neat. These are the blueprints of the future. The Walmart Supercenter. The revitalization of downtown. Oh, and of course, McDonald's and all stuff. But this is a big-time plant. The American-Italian Pasta Company.
Yeah.
And the Grand Hotels. But look how the elms evolved. That one that we just passed coming up here was this one. And it had all these, the whole side of it had all these stained glass windows that were all handmade, and they were incredible looking. I got some of this stuff in the basement. Well, no, in my garage. I've got a couple of plates. I've got some little teacup saucers and stuff.
Right.
Okay, so this is about the Hall of Waters, which is this building. And it's an Art Deco building of Excelsior Springs. And here's when they was building it. And that's that big room back there with all the windows. Mm-hmm. Oh, here's what it looked like when I worked here. And that's the swimming pool that's in the basement. There was an indoor swimming pool in the basement. It was the coolest thing. Okay, so she said if we walk back through this, that we can see. Hi. Museum? Okay, thank you. Oh, this has been here all my life. So the people would come from all over the world to get in these bathtubs. And each bathtub had different waters that could be pumped into it. And so there would be all kinds of people. And get this, you're not supposed to touch it. I won't touch it. You sit in it and your head stuck out. And it was supposed to like make you get skinny if you were fat. For real, and that's
I need the opposite
that's
of
what,
that.
That's what this one is too. I think this one's probably the older one than that. Yeah, probably. And then this was a spa room that you put your head out here, and the whole room filled with steam. But yeah, so this is pretty interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
They had a dill on it going like this, and they came up and you took a shower after you got in the bathtub. And then I don't know what all that was back there, but this is like, oh, see? And they were like this. And then this was had a chair behind it. And you sit in the chair and put your feet in it. And it was to, like, if you had feet arthritis. And then all this is just shows you all the different, you know, here's how hot you can be in it. And then that's just a little picture, you know, because there was all these attendants that worked in here. And then back in here, this was sort of like where the doctor kept the medicines and all that, because they administered medicine to them and stuff while, you know, they were in the spa. Just a bathroom, I guess, human resources. I don't know that I've never seen this before. But oh, I've got pictures of these in the garage. This one was iron and magnesium. This one was the sulfosaline. This one was the calcium. Oh, wait, there's some more here. Oh, that was Regent Springs. And I've got pictures of that one. Park Spring Letha. This one's saline. White Sulfur Spring. The sulfur stunk.
I mean, that's what you should do with all the old pictures. Donate them here.
I was going to take some of that stuff and give it to this museum down the street. Oh, look at this wooden water pipe on loan from the Excelsior Springs Museum and Archives. When have you ever seen a wooden water pipe?
Never.
Right? Not a very big museum, but interesting. Is this one of the ones that gave you your horoscope too? Nope.
Wait, did it actually...
Did it say how much you weighed? Oh, you don't weigh 230 pounds.
Yeah, I know that. Yeah. I weigh 95.
I don't think it works.
Yeah.
Can we go downstairs on the elevator to see the swimming pool?
Yep, if you go to M.
Go to M, yep. Okay. Because you got to see this. Here we come, M. M. And I don't know that I've ever seen elevators that have G and M. Ride. Oh. We can't enter, but we can at least look in.
Door opens.
Well, alright, look in. So, when I was a kid, this is where we used to come swimming at. This is where I learned to swim.
This is pretty cool.
And there's even a sub-basement below the swimming pool, and that's where they bottle the water.
Oh, they got like little lights here. All right. Let's go so we don't get in trouble.
I agree. Just in case there was a camera or something. Okay, so we just want to go back upstairs. And I've already forgotten what floor we got in on.
One.
One? Okay. That's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
That picture, the black and white one of the people bottling the water, that one was underneath that swimming pool. Oh, jeez. How about here? Oh, hello. Hold on, so this is the front. Up here. Oh, you can't use the steps and stuff anymore.
I see.
It used to be you could bring your family and sit out here and they had movies and you could have a picnic with your family.
Pretty damn cool.
I'll be inside.
All right.
Aren't the old Art Deco lamps cool?
Yeah.
see, if you look at it from different sides, it's different colors. One's orange, one's green. So that was the Hall of Waters, where they first started bottled water. Yep. Alrighty.